again, everyone, and welcome to our first Eddie Sutton show of the year. Tom Dirato with you, and obviously Eddie Sutton not here on his initial show. Sean Sutton, the associate head coach, is with us. And how's your dad doing? Not feeling very well.
Yeah, he's not feeling well, but I think he's getting better, and hopefully he'll be feeling much better Saturday night when we get ready to play the Razorbacks.
Well, that's important right there. Hopefully that game at Wichita didn't kind of increase his illness any, but give us an overview, Sean, as we try to catch our viewers up a little bit. We played four games. There have been some good things and some that you'd like to have to improve on.
Well, we're 3-1, and right now we've been a little bit inconsistent. We've played in spurts, and you've seen that throughout each game. We've had lapses for 4 or 5 minutes where we had a hard time scoring. We turned the ball over too many times during a segment like that. But our guys are learning. We like our basketball team. We like the talent we have on this team. They're hard workers on the practice court. And I think we'll continue to get better as the season goes on. I think the one thing we've had to do as a coaching staff when you bring in so many new players is you have to be patient. You have to be patient, and we've had to be patient with this basketball team, but we like their attitude, and I think as long as they'll continue to work, we'll get better.
Well, as we look at the highlight package from the first four games, we'll be able to show you some of those highs and lows you're talking about. And isn't that really indicative with a young team?
I think that happens, especially when you bring in as many new players as we have this season, and you're trying to incorporate them into a system. And we've struggled at times offensively. Obviously, we've turned the ball over entirely too many times, 79 turnovers in four games. Mm-hmm. We've been pretty pleased where our defense is now from where it was in the first exhibition game when we gave up 96 points against Athletes First.
And that's when you were coaching. That's when you had the defense. And finally, we took it out of your hands, and the defense got better beginning with this first game against UMKC.
It was a great pass from Mo Baker to Frederick.
And you see, defense was the name of the game over at the Mabee Center, our home away from home. And there's a newcomer, Melvin Sanders.
Great athlete, getting better every day on the practice court. Really think he'll develop into a fine basketball player before he leaves Oklahoma State. One thing about defense in this game, Tom, we held UMKC to 34 points with about a minute and 25 seconds to play in this game, and they were able to score 12 points. And Frederick and Andre and Jason Keep did a great job on their best player, Michael Jackson, mm-hmm. who was the Mid-Continent Conference Player of the Year a year ago.
You know, it's so hard to even look at Victor saying as being a newcomer, but this is his first division, not first Division I, here at Oklahoma State, Division I action, and he'd been out a year. Has he lost a little bit, you think?
I think you see that in transfer. You saw that with Brett Robish. Mm-hmm. It took him about a semester to kind of get in the groove when he transferred from Illinois. You saw the same thing with Glennon Alexander. After sitting out a year from Arkansas, it took him some time. And I think the more games Victor plays, the more comfortable and more relaxed he'll be.
Well, there's a competitor. We're going to see exactly what these guards, because Sanders goes in for the dunk. But our guard tandem with Victor and, of course, Mo Baker, we'll hear from him later in the show, guys who really energize a club.
Well, we've got very good quickness on the perimeter. We feel like that's one of the strengths of our basketball team is our ability to put defensive pressure on the opposing guards. And this is a great example in this game against North Texas. We forced a lot of turnovers. In fact, went on a 21-0 mm-hmm. run to, mm-hmm. to break the game open and end up leading 30-8 at that point. Great steal by Victor, good pass, good finish by Fred.
You know, you look at any road game, and again, the makeup of the crowd probably was more to our favor, another steal here, but this was a situation where the defense just took the fight out of North Texas.
It was a great steal by Terrence, and we were a little concerned going on the road for the first time with a young basketball team, how they were going to react, and they had about 5,600 fans there in Denton. Probably 2,000 of them were Cowboy fans, mm-hmm. but our guys really came out and took control of the game on the defensive end and really dictated the tempo the rest of the way, and we never looked back.
We're talking defense as you watch the highlights, and Andre with a good finish there. Cowboys allowing just 36% of the shots to go down, only 29% from three-point range. Out-rebounding opponents by 6, only giving up 58 points. So if you look across the board there, you have to be happy with those numbers.
Well, we've been pretty solid. We had some breakdowns, and we'll probably see these in a few minutes against Wichita State in the second half. But for the most part, we've been pretty solid at the defensive end. We've got to get our half-court offense a little bit smoother and quit turning the ball over as much.
We're going to move on to Game 3 as we continue the caravan of games. Now we go to the Myriad in Oklahoma City, and this was going to be really and turned out to be the first real tough test, UNLV.
Well, we had a really good crowd at the Myriad, almost 8,000 people, and I think UNLV is a very good basketball team. Anybody that had a chance to watch them over in Maui, they played against Coach Self's club at Illinois and gave them a great game before losing and then lost to Louisville by 1 in overtime. But I think UNLV will be an NCAA tournament team come March.
Did a great job on Kambala, their big man. He was basically no factor.
Another great effort by our inside people. They really frustrated him early, cost him, I think, 5 first half turnovers. He wasn't nearly as aggressive as he normally is. One key is we wanted to keep him off the foul line. He came in averaging 93% from the foul line, and we held him to 4 points in regulation and ended up getting 5 in overtime and 9 for the game. But anytime you can have that kind of performance against a quality basketball player like Kambala, you take that every night.
How about that move by Baker there, a little spin action all the way to the rim?
Very exciting player, great competitor, very good in broken court situations. I think that he's going to be, has a chance to be our best player this year because he's a warrior. He's a guy that brings it every day on the practice court, and he loves to win.
You talked about the peaks and valleys, and we got a little preview of maybe one of the valleys in this game. Had the game under control, let it get away in regulation, had to come back in overtime to win.
Well, we played well enough, we thought, the first half against UNLV to be up 17 to 20 points. We got up 11 at halftime. The second half, we came out and we could not put them away. And then we went into one of those lapses, and UNLV, I thought, played very well the second half and gave us some problems with their defense as well. And they got back into the game, and we were fortunate to win the basketball game.
Except for the Wichita State game and a good move underneath there by Fred, except for Wichita State, Andre's been active. Andre's been giving you pretty much what you want on both ends.
Well, Fred and Andre both came up big in this basketball game. They both scored in the low post late when we were struggling in our offense. Andre's a very much improved basketball player from where he was a year ago. He still has some improvement to make. I was a little concerned right there that he might have banked that off the back of the rim, but good play by Jason.
Did you teach Jason the break on that one right there? It was as smooth as silk. Hey, it's 2 points. Nobody complains about that.
Our guards did a very good job on Diggs and Lewis. Those two guys, I think, shot 8 for 25, and both of them are great three-point shooters and explosive scorers, and not very good defense right there if we didn't rotate over and take a charge on that particular play.
But here we come right back down the other end of the court, and that's the movement that you like with Maurice Baker, and look at that follow by Andre.
Great follow shot. He's a tremendous athlete, and I think as long as he continues to work, he'll get better and better. This is one area that he's really worked on. Very good low post move by Andre.
As you look at the club now, and we're getting into that situation where we had control, kind of gave it up there late in the game, but again, they had the resolve to come back in overtime and win that one. It almost happened the same way in Wichita, but that's a dangerous trend to get in.
Well, it's not one that you like. When you have a chance to put an opponent away, you need to put him away and seize that opportunity, and we fouled the second half way too many times in both games, but we were very proud in this game in Oklahoma City against Vegas, the fact that we had the lead. Vegas actually came back and got the lead, and we battled back and found a way to win. You see Victor, he hits these 2 free throws to force overtime, and then in overtime we jumped out and scored the first 8 points.
You're going to see his bucket after we get it into overtime. It put us up 4-0. Really a big bucket because it created a little comfort zone in the extra period. There's the last shot of regulation. What was going on the bench then?
Well, I think we were just happy that we'd got the game into overtime, and our guys really responded and came out and competed. During this 5-minute stretch, Victor on the down screen made a good curl and a good 15-foot jump shot there.
He missed a few of those in the game. It was good to see him hit that one late.
Great run through by Melvin, something that we want our perimeter players up in the passing lanes, trying to force turnovers, and that was a big play. They took it from 4 points to 6 points. Late in the game, it was a 2-point game. Great feed by Andre to cut him Fred down the paint, and that really sealed the game at that point.
Well, we knew that hopefully that this would not be the case, but we knew we were going into a very hostile environment because of the, as you had called on the radio, the friction between these two schools over the years, and it was tough.
Well, it's always been a great rivalry in baseball, and it was a great rivalry in basketball back in the 50s, and we started a 4-year series with Wichita State, and if you'll remember last year, they played us very tough in Gallagher, and we finished the game on a 16-0 run to win the game by 12, but there won't be many places that we play all year that the crowd will be as active and as hostile as what we saw last night in this particular game.
As you look at the way things are developing right here, we didn't play very well offensively, but well enough defensively to have that 10-point lead in control of the ball game.
We felt like at halftime we had not played well on offense, but still we were up 10 points. We had the game kind of where we wanted it. We emphasized to our team to come out of the second half. The first 4 or 5 minutes would be very crucial, and we wanted to try to extend our lead from 10 to 14 points, 15 points, and unfortunately, it went the other way. It went from 10 points to 2 points in a hurry. And Wichita State, you got to give them a lot of credit. Mark Turgeon's done a great job with their basketball team. They're playing with a lot of confidence, and they really competed hard the second half.
Just couldn't keep them off the free throw line enough in the second half, and they didn't really have a great night from the charity stripe, but good enough to keep us at arm's length, and then they kind of spurted at the end.
Too many fouls the second half. They got 27 free throw attempts, and that was one of the emphasis we had on this game, not to put them on the foul line, and we got ourselves in foul trouble. Andre and Frederick and Victor all had to go to the bench with four fouls, and there you see the last shot. We set up kind of a two-man play with Mo and Fred, and got a wide-open 15-foot shot and didn't make the shot.
Okay, so four games in now. Cowboys are 3-1, as we mentioned, suffering their first loss at Wichita. Overall, from a coaching staff's viewpoint, how do you view this club? Obviously, some improvement to make, but there's some good things as well.
We have a lot of improvement to make, but I think the thing that has carried us up to this point has been our half-court defense, and I think that's an area that we'll continue to get better in. I mentioned our quickness on the perimeter. I think we've got excellent quickness out there that can really disrupt the other team's offense. The one area that we've got to continue to get better in is our half-court offense, and we've got to take care of the ball and not be so careless with our turnovers.
Well, if you like to travel, you're going to enjoy our first off-the-court feature on the Eddie Sutton Show. It all comes up after this opening timeout. You know, ever since the workouts began back in October, every day has been a road trip for the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Get in a van, get in a bus, drive your own car, get to practice or to the game any way you can. Truly, Willie Nelson had OSU in mind when he came up with this popular On the Road Again. It's a song that this basketball team can certainly appreciate.
Road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, going places that I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way and our way. Road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way and our way. Road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
That is a great piece. It has been a bit of a struggle, a little bit of an inconvenience for this basketball team, not having a place to practice consistently every day. But for the most part, our staff's been very proud of our young players for the way they've adjusted to this. But we're looking forward to getting back into Gallagher where we can have some consistency in our practice. But I think it'll be well worth the wait. I think this is going to be a facility that everybody can be very proud of at Oklahoma State, and we're certainly looking forward to getting there on December 19th against Arkansas Little Rock.
If you could get frequent flyer miles for van trips and cars and things like bus rides, you guys would be going to Europe probably for free at somebody's expense.
We'd be in great shape in that situation.
You know, you talk about first impressions. Well, Maurice Baker has been impressive over the first four games. We'll talk with Mo on our player feature when we come back to the Eddie Sutton Show.
Now it's time for the Big Time Sports Apparel Player Spotlight. Each week we feature the cowboy who typifies the big time attitude to dig down deeper. This week's cowboy player in the spotlight is Maurice Baker. Congratulations, when you wear big time, dig down deeper.
Well, welcome back to the show, and we're in the interview pit, if you will. We want to let you guys trying to remember what it was like, you especially, what it was like in Gallagher-Iba. We're sitting in the old seats right here.
Can't wait to get back in there and sit.
Eventually, somebody's going to sit in these kinds of seats again. Mo is in the spotlight with us. And Mo, first of all, congratulations for being Big 12 Player of the Week this past week. And you bring that intensity that Sean says to the game every day, practice, game. That's exactly what was predicted when you got here.
Yeah, I just like to play hard all the time. Coaching them always on me to play hard, and I've been playing hard all my life, so I'm not going to stop now.
You told me all about him when you recruited him.
Well, he was one of the best players in junior college a year ago. In fact, played for an excellent basketball coach who was actually on the staff at Kentucky when I was a player and worked for my dad. And Maurice has been everything that we thought he would be. He's a big-time competitor. He leads by example every day on the practice court. And there's a reason he's playing the best basketball on the team right now. It's because every day on the practice court, he goes out and he plays hard than anybody on our team. And you look at the stats right now, it shows that averaging 17 points and 7 rebounds and kind of in the mode of rebounding like Randy and, mm-hmm. and Peterson. Those two guys were great rebounders from the backcourt as well.
It has to be a knack. We talked about this on one of the radio shows. It's a knack for a guard to rebound. You've got to anticipate, get yourself in a position. It's not like you're 6'10". You got to make sure you got that guy blocked off and you're quicker than he is.
It's like guards are not really used to boxing out, so I sneak in around a big man and get the rebound.
Yeah, I imagine that'll be on somebody's scouting report from here on out. You bring the intensity to the court, and again, we go back to the game at Wichita State. I mean, down the stretch, you wanted the basketball in your hands, try to make something happen, and I'll be darned, we almost got it done at the end.
Yeah, Coach Nim was telling me to make something happen and do what I do best, and just like try to take over the game, get my team involved.
You remind me of a lot of guys who played here. When the game's not coming out our favor, you could tell he's not a very happy camper.
Well, like I said, he is a great competitor, and he's a guy that really is capable of scoring in a lot of different ways. He's got great penetration off the dribble. He can shoot the three-point shot. He's a terrific foul shooter. And like you said, Tom, that really separates good players from great players. When the game is on the line, you want guys that want the ball in their hands, and he's one of those guys.
You don't want guys to have to run off and hide and look for him to get him the ball. You and Victor in the backcourt, you bring a lot of energy, you bring a lot of quickness, and you can disrupt a lot of teams defensively.
Yeah, Coach, when I was coming in, Coach was always talking we can have a good backcourt defensively. I mean, Vic just run hard and play hard all the time. That's why I think we're playing good right now.
Well, we certainly enjoy you being here. We appreciate you being on the first show. Continued good success. We're going to come back, and when we do, we've got the notebook, the question of the week. We'll be back to talk to you right after this timeout. Well, welcome back to the show, and lucky you. You get a chance to take on the first question of the year and the first notebook, and we go right to that question. Now, what about Glendon Alexander?
Well, Glendon has petitioned for another semester, and right now we've turned in the paperwork, and it's just a matter of time for the Big 12 faculty reps meet and decide on Glendon's case, and we'll hope that they will rule favorably, and we can get him back because he's a tremendous three-point shooter and would certainly be a big addition to our basketball team the second semester.
Now, this is a very popular segment, especially with you there. He can't wait to find out what we come up with each week on the notebook, and we're going to get to it right here. We got three items as usual, and the first one's going to have to do with free throw shooting, and we saw a contest up there at Wichita.
Well, one of the point of emphasis with the rules committee this year, Tom, is obviously to cut down on the rough play in the post and out on the perimeter, and they're calling the game a little bit tighter than you've seen in the past, trying to put more finesse in the game of basketball. And you saw that the second half against UNLV, and you saw it against Wichita State on Wednesday night. And if the officials are going to call the game tight, then the players are going to have to learn to adjust to the officiating.
Now you get a chance to brag on your fellow colleagues in the office, Keller and Cyprian.
Kyle Keller, Glenn Cyprian are both super guys and excellent basketball coaches, and very glad and very pleased they're a part of our staff because they do a lot for us on an everyday basis.
Pretty good guys, too.
Great guys.
I hate to say that, but pretty good guys, nevertheless. And our last item will have to be with leadership. Who's going to step up and take the lead right here?
Well, we hope, we were hoping that Frederick or Andre, and that's one of the areas that we're a little concerned with right now, but hopefully in the next week or two we'll have a little bit more leadership on the practice court every day.
Okay, 7 o'clock Saturday night, Arkansas, they're 6-1. And what a rivalry this could become over the years.
Big game, should be an exciting game between two great programs that have done very well in the NCAA tournament the last decade, and we're looking forward to the contest. Arkansas, like you said, has a very good basketball team. They've got a great player in Joe Johnson, who's an All-American candidate. Coach Richardson's teams always play hard and always put a lot of defensive pressure on you, so we're looking forward to the match Saturday night in the Mabee Center.
Well, Mabee Center, 7 o'clock again over in Tulsa. Be there. We appreciate you being with us this week. For Sean Sutton, sitting in for his dad, Mo Baker, and everybody here at Educational Television Services. Tom Dirato, goodbye, everybody.